I think it's very important if we want to deal with the whole challenge of sustainability that it becomes a part of our mental processes, part of our cultural heritage, and also a definition of the future. And I think all of that requires us to treat nature and the preservation of nature with a certain level of reverence. And therefore, I would say that the concept of sacred groves, in other words, things that we believe have to be maintained in the way they are only because they are sacred, really makes a lot of sense. And I think if we were to accept that, particularly in an urban setting, that for instance, if there's a park, however small it may be, it has to be kept as a beautiful park. And it's something that you don't throw any litter on, you don't pollute in any way. And I think what we really need is setting up these sacred groves where a particular society treats the whole concept of sacredness with something that they relate to easily. And I think if we can do that in a few settings, in a few demonstration projects, I think the message can then be disseminated on a large scale. Right?
Yes, very good. Thank you for that.
And the cultural factor, why is culture so important to sustainable development?
Culture, I think, is extremely important because after all, it is the evolution of human thinking, human practices, human behavior over a long period of time. And much of this is based not on instantaneous solutions, but something that has evolved over a long period of time through the wisdom of generations before us. And this is what culture is. Culture is really the accumulation of wisdom over the ages. It's something that has been handed down from our forefathers to their children and so on and so forth. And therefore, I think it is the accumulation, the embodiment of traditional wisdom. And it also defines certain bounds of behavior. I mean, a culture lays down practices which are acceptable, practices which are respected, and it also identifies practices that should never be pursued. You know, violence, for instance, or non-violence are an essential part of culture. And I think this is what really makes life something that is based on mutual respect and a set of relationships that are very much at the core of culture. So I think if we want to bring about change, if we want to see that the future of the human race is one that supports sustainability, then we have to build this on the cultural platform that exists already in several parts of the world. And culture differs from one place to the other. So you also have to take into account the local reality of cultural values and then build on it. If you want to transport, let's say, culture from Saudi Arabia to a country like Mongolia, it's not going to work because they are living under very different conditions. Their priorities, their concerns, their challenges are vastly different. And therefore, I think you have to build on the local reality of culture as it has evolved in a particular location. And I believe that's extremely important because otherwise you could have a terrible mismatch in terms of solutions, in terms of initiatives, and the cultural reality, which has to be every part of the solution.